The wandering albatross is the largest of all among the 22 or so albatross species in the world. With a wingspan of 3.5 meters, it is the world's oldest known wild bird. Albatross mate for life, but if they outlive their mates, they will choose a new mate. They can be found on all the oceans around Antarctica. The ancient mariners blamed the albatross for the bad weather, and these birds were killed because mariners shot them out of superstitions in the hope that the storm would settle down. When albatrosses and seabirds in general meet fishing vessels, they often follow the vessels for days and fall for the fish. They get caught in the hooks or gill nets because they dive for the baits. They die in their hundreds of thousands as an undesirable bycatch of the fishing industry. Despite the many inaccuracies hidden behind the reported figures from the fishing industry, alarming estimates have been made. More than 300,000 seabirds are therefore falling victim to fishing vessels every year. It is estimated that 3 billion fewer wild birds soar the skies than in 1970. Seabird mortality in fishing gear is a globally recognized issue and is believed to be responsible for declines of many bird populations. Seabirds get hooked on long lines, become entangled in gill nets, collide with trawler cables, and become trapped in trawl nets and fish traps. Another big concern is that seabirds have full plastic stomachs. Almost 300 pieces of plastic have been counted on a single bird. To give us an idea, it is as if a human being had 8 kilograms of plastic in the digestive tract. Can you imagine that? People need to pay attention to the birds around them because they are slowly disappearing. One of the scary things about the results is that it's happening right under our eyes. We might not even notice until it's too late. It's not just about the government responsibility or the fishing industry. We as consumers must do our part.